So next topic, interfacing of DAC with 8051 microcontroller. Okay, so DAC is a short form of digital to analog converters, which convert our digital inputs, that is binary input 1 0, to the analog output. Okay, so this is a circuit diagram for how to interface DAC IC. Digital to analog converter or analog to digital converters available in the form of integrated circuit, right? DAC 0808. So I'm going to use DAC 0808, DAC IC. So this is the major part. The output of this digital to analog converters available in the form of current only, I out. So again, we have to convert this current into voltage. So this circuit arrangement is current to voltage converter, I to V converter, using operational amplifier. Okay, so we'll be studying in more detail about this operational amplifier and its characteristics in the next semester in the IC integrated circuits and application subject. Okay, now you just understand the block level meaning. DAC IC, output available in the form of current, so we need to convert into voltage. So this particular circuit, this operational amplifier circuit, doing that particular work. And to measure the output voltage, I am using the voltmeter here. This is digital voltmeter, which is available in your Proteus software, and also you can use the probe also. You can use the probe or you can use a digital voltmeter. And I'm connecting port 3 of microcontroller with this digital to analog converter. These are the inputs, A1 to A8. These are the inputs of digital to analog converters IC. Okay. Next, P1. Through port 1, I'm giving my binary input. That will be reflect on port 3. Port 3 connected as input to digital to analog converter. So this output current converted into voltages. Okay, so this input circuit diagram look like clumsy, but I'll explain to you what is connected over here. Last, say for example, port 1, I'm explaining default. If this is default, meaning it's 5 volt. Okay, this is a power supply, so I have connected a 5 volt power supply and a resistor. Okay, this resistor connected to the switch and connected to P1.0. this switch is connected with the ground. That's it. So this arrangement, again from the same line, one more resistor and connected to P11, another resistor connected to P12, and so on, from plus 5 volt resistor P10 through resistor P11 through resistor P11 and so on, last resistor P12. This is the arrangement, and one switch also connected with this. So whenever the switch is open, the P10 getting logic high input, that is plus 5 volt. Okay, whenever the switch is closed, it is short circuited with the ground. Now the input is considered as binary zero. So we are applying digital inputs. Okay, that is ones and zero. So depending on the switch position, whether we are applying logic high to the port one or logic zero to the port one. If it is open, logic high. If it is closed, logic zero. Okay. So that is what I have done in the input side. You can select a single pole, single through switch, and commonly one ground position. Through that, you connect total 8 switches. So I'm going to use 8-bit DAC converter. My digital inputs are 8-bit information. So P17, least significant bit. P10 is the most significant bit. Okay, say for example 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, it represents all these switches are open. All these switches are open. 0000000 input represents all these switches are closed. That is ground potential. Similarly, you may give 2^8 combinations are possible. For each and every input combination, you will get a unique analog output. You can read that value in the voltmeter also or in the probe also. Okay, so this is the interfacing diagram of DAC IC with a microcontroller directly. Okay, the circuit connection, you just make a connection as per this diagram. DAC IC have a reference voltage, that is V reference. Here I have given +5 volt V reference through a resistor, and the I out, this is your output pin, which is connected to current to voltage converter. Then minus V reference should be connected to ground. Sorry, this one minus V reference connected to ground. Okay, and between compensation and VEE, one capacitor is connected. This is minus 15 volt. So this is a circuit arrangement for digital to analog converters. So there are different types of digital to analog converter circuits are available. You will be studying in detail in integrated circuits application in the next semester. So particularly DAC0808 digital to analog converter uses the principle called as R2R ladder network. R2R ladder network. This is a pin diagram of DAC0808. It has 18 pins. Okay, no connection, ground, VEE. This is your output pin where you will get current output. Then A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8. These are your input pins. The most significant bit, it is least significant. So VCC plus reference volt. Plus reference volt is important because if you are keeping plus reference volt is 5 volt, if all the switches kept at logic high input, if all the inputs are 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, you will get the output here 5 volt. It depends on what reference voltage you are keeping. Suppose if you are keeping your reference voltage is 10 volt, for all the inputs are logic high, you will get 10 volt. So do you understand? So between 0 volt to 5 volt. In this example, I'm going to use 5 volt reference only, 5 voltage reference only. So 8-bit input, meaning 2^8, I think 256 combinations. So you will get 256 combination between 0 volt to 5 volt as the output for a corresponding input. If all inputs are 0000000, your output voltage is 0. If all the inputs are 1 1 1 1 1, your output voltage is 5 volt. Why this 5 volt? Because we are going to use V reference as 5 volt. Okay. So in this DAC0808 IC, have the circuits of only R2R ladder network, only this particular portion. That's it. Only this particular portion available in the IC. So your output is current available at the fourth pin. Output available at the fourth pin. There is current only, I out. Then that I out has to be connected to I to V converter. So this is operational amplifier. So the circuit diagram, the feedback resistor, or you will get analog output voltage V0. Okay. So the equation for current output from the R2R ladder network, that is exactly at this particular point. At this particular point, your output current is equal to I reference. I reference equal to whatever V reference you are keeping, from that some current will be drawn. Right? So this is I reference. I reference into, so in this example, I have taken only 4-bit D0, D1, D2, D3. So this output current is equal to डी नॉट डिवाइडेड बाय 256 प्लस डी वन डिवाइडेड बाय 128 प्लस डी टू डिवाइडेड बाय 64. दिस इज फॉर 8 बिट. ओके, दिस इज फॉर 8 बिट इंफॉर्मेशन. फॉर द सिंप्लिसिटी आई हैड शोन इन दिस एग्जांपल only bit. So D naught, D1, D2, D3 up to D7. So current at this particular point, that will be equal to I reference D naught by 256, D1 by 128 and so on up to D7 by 27. I reference is your reference voltage drawn from your source voltage V reference. Okay, but we have to convert this current into voltage. So this particular circuit diagram doing that work. And why this circuit called as R2R ladder network? So this ladder follows a fixed resistance value. If this is R, this should be 2R. R may be anything. You may keep any value for R, but it should be 2 times of R. R2R, R2R, R2R. At last, it will be terminated with 2R. That's why this ladder network called as R2R ladder network. So what is the speciality of the circuit? If you are designing a circuit like this, R2R manner, if you apply the Kirchhoff current law analysis, a KVL law analysis, in the first 2R, the current flow through this first resistor is I by 2. If this is I reference, if this is I reference by 2. The next network, the current flow through this particular resistor is I by 4, I by 8, I by 16 and so on. Okay, so this is some introduction about R2R ladder network. So DAC0808IC follows this R2R ladder network concept only. Externally, we have to connect this current to voltage converter with the fourth pin of your IC. Okay. Anyway, we are not going to use this equation because we'll be getting the expression V out. Okay. So what is the expression for V out at this particular point? So V out equal to V reference. V out equal to V reference. Whatever V reference voltage you are applying to your circuit. Multiplied with D naught by 2, D1 by 4, and so on. So this is the part. Or we can write it as a general equation. The output voltage of your digital to analog converter at last. After current to voltage conversion, output to voltage equal to V reference divided by 2 power n. N represents number of binary inputs into 2 power n minus 1 into B n minus 1 plus and so on plus 2 power 1 B 1 plus 2 power 0 B 0. So this is the formula for DAC output. Okay, so B naught represents least significant bit and this point most significant bit. So we are going to use 8 bit. So this is B0 to B7. Suppose if you are applying all the inputs are 000, that is B naught to B7000, then you will get output as 0 volt. If reference voltage 10 volt. Suppose our binary input is 10000. Okay, our binary input is 10000. Should become first. Okay, in the reverse order, they have written. That is the least significant bit is 1. Okay, so 2 power n available here now. Okay, right. So I'm not going to use. This is sufficient. Okay, so follow these equations. So follow this equation. This is a better, simple one. So depending on our binary inputs, you will get the reference voltage V out. Sorry, output voltage V out. Okay, B naught is the least significant bit. B n minus 1 represent most significant bit. Okay, now how to write the program? So we discussed the circuit arrangement of digital to analog converter IC with the microcontroller, and the outputs converted into voltage. And we know the formula, the output of this operational amplifier after converting I to V, that should be equal to V reference by 2 power n. Where n represents number of binary input. N represents number of binary inputs. And V reference is reference voltage. Okay, that's it. Okay. Now we will write the program. It's very simple program only. So port one here we are using as the input, right? To configure port one as input, I'm loading FF to port one. Configure port one as input. Okay. To act as input port, we have to load 1 to the corresponding port that we studied in the internal circuit diagram of all the ports of the microcontroller. Next, move A, P1. And also, we have connected a switches to the port 1 to indicate 0. If the switch is connected with the ground, then it is 0. If the switch is open, then +5 volt, this +5 volt will be applied to the particular port through the resistor. So that is logic. So depending on the status of the switch, whatever information available at the port 1, that is moved to accumulator. Then we connected a DAC with port 3, so accumulator information moved to port 3. Do this work continuously, so S jump again. Okay, read the status of inputs and move to accumulator and transform those data into port 3, where port 3 connected with our DAC IC. Okay. Just 4 line programs, but you have to make the connection carefully in the Proteus software. Okay, so what is the first step? Convert this assembly language into hex file. Using Keel software, convert this assembly language program into hex file. That is machine executable file. Then keep ready with your hex file. So open the Proteus software. Okay, so microcontroller. So already I given the demonstration in the Proteus how to use the Proteus software. microcontroller. This is your switches, and also the plus 5 volt connected through the resistor to each and every port. P10, P11, P12, and up to P17 is 5 volt connected through the resistor. At the same time, each port connected with the ground through a switch. Okay, if switch is closed, if the switch is closed, it represents zero. If the switch is open position, it represents plus 5 volt will be connected to port. Okay. And what are the new element in this particular experiment for you? Resistor, already you are using, you are doing experiment in electronic circuits. So whatever you are doing in the PSPICE, same concept here also. We have from the part list, we have to select a resistor, and you can edit the value of this resistor. And switches, then DAC, IC, and here also resistor, ground, and operational amplifier, op amp, voltmeter, and capacitor, and probe. Okay, so I'll tell you the microcontroller, resistor, and switches, and DAC, IC, and operational amplifier. This all you have to select from part list. If you click on this P, you'll get the part list will come. You can type it, whichever device you want, you can type. Say for example, resistor, if you want, just type resistor, you will get resistor. Similarly, if you want the capacitor, and select capacitor. Okay. And suppose single pole, single through switch, SW, SP, ST. Because many switches are available, it's better to select these kind of switches. Okay. So from the part list, we may select the switches, resistor, microcontroller, DAC, IC, and operational amplifier and capacitor. From where we have to select this ground and this plus 5 volt and this probe and all, I'll tell you. So on the left side of this toolbar, this is part list symbol. Okay, this is part list symbol. Next, if you click on this one, you will get power, ground and all. Terminals. This is terminals. Okay. You have to click on this terminals, so input, output, or power, ground, everything will be available in the terminal mode. Next, this is the probe. Okay, if you want a voltage probe, by default, voltage probe will be selected. So we are going to measure the voltage only. So I have selected a voltage probe that I kept here. This is the voltage probe. Next, voltmeter. So instrument, lot of instrument available. Here I have selected a DC voltmeter. Okay, select a DC voltmeter, and I have connected the DC voltmeter here. Okay, done, everything done. So power, by default 5 volt power only. By default it is 5 volt power. So once you select power, we click on this. So power. By default, this is 5 volt. So if you want to edit your voltage, just double click on that. In the string, you have to type. Suppose if you want to make it as 10 volt, then in the string, you have to give plus 10 volt. And you get 10 volt. Okay. So any doubt? I told you which are the elements we should take in from the part list. Apart from major component, this ground and this power supply, and wherever I have connected the power supply, this you have to take in from terminals. Next, probe. Probe directly available. This is the probe symbol. We need to use voltage probe, so select voltage probe. Next to volt meter, this symbol, instrument symbol, there you have to select a DC voltmeter. This is your voltmeter. Digital DC voltmeter. Okay. So you practice the circuit diagram. I will post the material today. So whatever the connection available in the circuit diagram, you have to give the connections in the Proteus software. In DAC IC, I have connected V references 5 volt. Minus V reference connected to ground. Between VEE and the compensation, I have connected one capacitor and kept it minus 5, 15 volt. This is the actual output, current output. So if you want to measure the current at this particular pin also, you may go with the probe and current. And you can keep it here. It's not selected. I'm not very sure. I am not right. Okay, I'll try and let you know. Okay, circuit connection introduction is over now. Keel software. Project. So under DAC folder, I created one project already. It's a simple program. P1 status. Mode to P3 through accumulator, that's it. So select output, hex file, and target and everything. And now build it. Rebuild it. Your hex file will be generated. Now go to the Proteus software, double click on this, select the hex file, and load. Then run it. Run option available here. Run this. Okay. So now all the switches are open. See here, 4.99 volt. I kept reference voltage plus 5 volt. So 4.99 volt. Suppose if I connect all the switches. Okay, all the switches are connected. It meaning port 1.0 to port 1.7 connected with the ground. So you'll get 0 volt. Ideally, you should get 0 volt, but getting a minimum volt. 0.1 also not good. You should get 0.00 something. Anything is open. Okay. Ideally, we should get 0 volt, but it's not possible. So minimum 0.00 something voltage, you will get it. If all the inputs are connected at 0. Suppose 0000000011. I'm giving. Now check your voltage. You're getting some voltage, 3.9 volt. Similarly, you can verify using that formula, V out equal to V reference divided by 2 power n. okay, B0 2 power 0 plus B1 2 power n, and so on. Using that formula, you can manually calculate your analog output voltage corresponding for your digital input, and you can verify that output here also. So all inputs are 1, 4.9. So any doubt regarding this concept? This topic available in your theory as well as laboratory experiment also. Write an assembly language program for interfacing DAC with 8051 microcontroller and demonstrate using Proteus software. And if you refer some YouTube video and some other lecture, they may use push button switches, but don't go for push button switches, right? So this may be a good one actually. Okay. So DAC basic concept. And what is R2R ladder network, and how are we converting the output current into voltage with the help of the operational amplifier? Okay, and the fundamental formula is this formula. Eight-bit binary or eight-bit digital to analog converter circuits. Or 8-bit DAC IC we are using for this particular concept. That is sufficient. Okay. So any doubt in this, or shall we move to next one? So next one is generation of square waveform, triangular waveform, and staircase waveform. Okay, so you may write the program separately, but in this example, I have written a single program to generate a square waveform. First, I am generating a square waveform. Okay, after that, I am generating. Yeah, triangular waveform. Once triangular waveform I completed, after that I am generating a staircase waveform with the steps of initially 0 and then 1, 2, 3 steps. 1, 2, 3 steps. Okay, and repeat the same process again and again. This is objective. Write an assembly language program to generate a square waveform or triangular waveform or staircase waveform. Sorry, and square waveform and triangular waveform and staircase waveform. Okay, so P1, P2, P3. I'm using P1 port 1 for generating this waveform, port 2 for this waveform, port 3. At a time, I wanted to display all these three signal, but one by one only, simultaneously not possible. One subroutine for generating square waveform and one subroutine for generating triangular waveform and one subroutine for generating staircase waveform and one subroutine for delay and one subroutine for delay. Okay, first A call square wave, so hit the square waveform, port 1. Move FF to port 1. FF meaning 1111. Okay. FF hexadecimal. Decimal equivalent for FF 256. Right? All are 111. A call delay. So this is a delay program. This delay program written with the help of timer register. You decode it. What is the mode of this timer and which timer register I am using with the help of tmod register. You decode it. Okay, this is just for a delay. FF, it's logic high. A call delay, call the delay program. Once the delay is completed, again 0 0. Okay, this is FF, this is 0 0, right? Finished. So one pulse completed. Next, return to the main program. Next line, A called triangular waveform. So this is a subroutine for triangular waveform. I taken R7 as the register. Initially zero. So send it to port 2. Increment R7. Right? Compare jump on not equal to R7 00 FF. So from 00 to FF, increment step by step, one by one. Okay, that is the statement here. Compare jump on not equal R7 FF. If R7 is not equal to FF, go to here. So move your R7 value to P2. So you will get in the P2 port. From 0, slowly the data will be increasing, the value will be increasing. Once it reaches this particular value, reference value, then again this may be false. Compare jump on not equal, then only go there. If R7 equal to FF, next line will be executed. Now what we need to, we have to generate this decreasing part, right? For that, now assign FF to R7 and move to port 0 and decrement your R7. Previously, we that's incremented R7 0 to FF. Now FF to 00 decrement. Decrement jump on no 0 R7. FF and then FE, FD, FC and so on up to 0. Okay, if not 0, repeat the same procedure. If it is 0, return. 0 meaning completed, our triangular waveform completed, return. Return meaning it will go to the main program. Next line, A called staircase. So this is a staircase program. Initially 0. You may take any value. I have taken randomly some value, 324080. 32H meaning convert the 32H into a hexadecimal value, sorry, decimal value. 40H to decimal value, 80H to decimal value. In this example, FF represents, you will get maximum voltage, right? I think plus 5 volt you will get. 00 represents, you will get 0. So in between, if you select, you will get the voltage range between this 0 to 5 volt. So initially I make 00 at port 3. And delay, give some delay. Next 32, give some delay. Next to 40, give some delay. Next 80. Okay, and then return. Return meaning it will return to your main program. Jump repeat. A call square, again A call triangular, and A call staircase wave. So simple program, but within the program we have generated square waveform as well as triangular waveform as well as staircase waveform, one by one, port 1, port 2, port 3 I used. For generating a delay, I am using a timer circuit. 000001, what is the mode of operation? T mode. All are 00001, that is timer 0. Timer 0, mode 1. Okay, timer 0, mode 1. 01 meaning mode 1, that is 16-bit timer mode. It's not required to accurate. You may use some simple delay also by taking some register loaded with the FF and decrement the register up to 0. In the previous example we used for generating time delay, this method also you can use, no issue. take some registers and load some value, decrement those register up to zero. This will also give some delay. So if you want to give some predefined time delay calculation, then it's better to go with timer register. So depending on what value we are loading in THTL, we may calculate the total time delay. Okay, so this is for timer initialization. The value to be loaded into timer register, start your timer, wait until your timer overflow flag is set. Once overflow occurred, again clear your TR0 and TF0 and return. Where you called, return meaning next line. Say for example, let us assume A call delay. From this particular point, we are calling that program. After completion, return. Return meaning it will come to the next line of program. A call delay, after execution of everything, then it will come to this particular next line. Okay. So let us simulate this Keel software in the laboratory. If you use CRO, we can able to visualize this square waveform and a triangular waveform and a staircase waveform in the CRO directly. So I created the project already. My project name is waveform generation. Waveform generation. Okay. So the same code I have copied here, and I have selected device and names, and then if you want to give 11.0592, if you want a hex file generation output, create hex file generation, zero error, build it, zero error, rebuild it, zero error. Okay, now we go for debugging session. So before run this code, go to oscilloscope or analyzer. Sorry, analyzer. In that analyzer, I have selected already. So this window will be appear. Go to setup. Type P1. I'll show you. Okay. After selection of analyzer, you will get the window like this. Go to setup. P1, right? First square waveform. Next P2 for triangular waveform. Next P3 for staircase waveform. Just three steps only I give one. Close it. So P1, P2, P3. Now you run the code. Okay. So you can stop and see that. So I have generated a square waveform first. On time, off time, depending on the delay period. And once the square waveform completed, again my another subroutine will started executing. That subroutine I have written for a triangular waveform. From zero it is increasing. Okay, so once the triangular waveform completed, then I called subroutine for staircase waveform. Only three steps I given, initially zero, and step 1, step 2, step 3. Okay, then this value will be maintained until the next service routine, next step, or next time the service routine will be executed. So next again the square waveform generated, then triangular waveform generated, next staircase waveform, and so on. Okay, so this waveform we can visualize with the help of CRO.